If you're like me and you cannot knit to save your life, or you want to learn how to make a scarf in under 30 minutes, then I have the perfect tool for you.
I'm Little John Yarns. I come up with new patterns every single week, so make sure you hit the subscribe button and the notification bell so you're always up to date.
Today, we're going to be doing something a little bit different. We're having a designer spotlight of Claudia Bostic, and I want to introduce you to this machine. If you've never seen the Addi King Express, you're definitely missing out. This is for something for those who can't knit like myself. It's a 46 needle circular knitter. What you do, you put your hand on the crank and you just crank out beautiful knit tubes and flat panels that you can create into anything. I'll leave some pictures of some of the things that I made on the Addi King Express. And if you'd like more information about the Addi King Express, I made a video about that. I'll leave a link for that video above and a link down in the description below. But let's get into the meat of the topic. We're talking about Claudia Bostic's Granny Square Cowl that she created because we're doing a designer spotlight. She is a wonderful designer. She's created many patterns on this machine. If you're interested in learning more about her, she has a Facebook group. It's called CC the Chesney Yarn and Craft. I'll leave all her information down in the description below. Make sure you check her out. And thank you, Claudia, for sharing your pattern with us today. And if you want to be featured as in the designer spotlight, just leave a comment down below. I'll contact you and we can feature your pattern or just a picture of your work and your business information. And so we can get traffic to your page or anything that you're looking for or just a wonderful shout out for yourself. All right. Oh, one more thing. Make sure you get your Crochet Queen t-shirt. I'll leave all that information down in the description box below and use the coupon code YARN and you'll get a 10% discount on this t-shirt. Okay, guys, I'm done talking, so we'll hop right into Claudia's pattern and let's hop into it. We're going to be following Claudia's pattern to the T. I began with a normal cast on, and I did about five rows of waisted yarn. This helped in finding the ends when it's time to bind off or single crochet your scarf close. If you don't understand, you will later in this tutorial. So once you got your five rows of waist yarn, you're going to cut your yarn that's on your machine, open up your feeder, and drop that waist yarn down below because we're no longer working with it. And next, we're going to add in our new yarn. I like to leave a nice long tail for single crocheting later, or for those who knit, binding off later. So, add your yarn, close your feeder, and set your counter back to zero. According to Claudia, we are going to do 130 rows or 26 inches, whatever you hit first. So, I'll start the first row with you. I like to go extremely slow on my first row because I don't want to drop any stitches. Because with drop stitches, you have to go back and fix. It's pretty simple to do though. So once you make it around your very first row, okay, I get that, you can speed up a little bit. So continue doing your 130 rows or 26 inches, whatever comes first, and I'll meet you once you get there. Okay, we've made it back around, and what I'm going to do, I'm going to open up my feeder and toss the leftover yarn down into the center because I don't have that much, and I'm just going to use this to single crochet close or for those who knit to bind off. And now, to make it simple, I'm just going to add on my waist yarn. Reset my counter, and I'm going to do about five rows of waist yarn, and then I'm going to take the thing off the machine. So you can pause your video here and continue doing your last five rows of waist yarn. Okay, we did our five rows of waist yarn, and all you have to do is cut your end and crank your wheel and your work will come right off the machine. All right, and we'll move on to the very next step. Here's what your work looks like so far. And what we're going to do now is single crochet the front and the back together. We're going to be working into the loops. Locate your waist yarn end and you'll be able to recognize the loops that we'll be working into. See here, these are the yellow ones. We're not working into the yellow ones, but your main color right here. Here's a loop we'll be working into. Here's a loop. Here's a loop. All right. To locate where to start, find your tail end right here. And where that tail is located, that will be the first part you put your crochet hook into.
That'll be the front loop. And the matching one behind it is right there. That's the back loop. And we're just going to slip stitch this first one. And we're going to single crochet the rest of the stitches together. So go into the front, find that back loop, back, single crochet together. Find the front, back, single crochet together. One more time, front loop, pick up the adjacent back loop, single crochet together. All right, you can pause your video here. Continue placing single crochets all the way down to the other side, and I'll meet you at the other side. All right, we made it to the other side, and you can fasten off your work. Quick tip, if you made it to the very end and you ended up with an odd number of loops to single crochet, that means you missed a stitch. Go back, make sure you crochet right, because once you remove your waist yarn, it will turn into a drop stitch. All right, go ahead and do the exact same thing on the other side, and I'll meet you when that's complete. If you find this part of the video is moving too fast, just look for the little gear button at the bottom of your screen. Click that, and you can adjust the speed to your liking. We're going to begin by making a basic granny square, and I'm switching between two colors. So to start, we're going to make a magic ring. After you make your magic ring, chain three. One, two, three. Your chain three will count as a double crochet. We're going to place two more double crochets into the ring. One, two. We're going to call this a cluster, three double crochets together. Now we're going to chain two, one, two, and we're going to do another cluster into the ring. That's three double crochets. One, two, and three. Chain two. One, two. We're going to do that two more times by putting three double crochet into the ring, chain two, and we're going to put three double crochet into the ring again and chain two. I'll meet you back when you have that completed. So pause your video here. Okay, we made it to the other side and I already completed my last chain two. You should have four clusters. One, two, three, four. Now we're going to slip stitch to join into the top of your chain three stitch. So one, two, three, there's the top. And slip stitch to join. And we're going to fasten off our work and we're going to switch off to the very next color. All right, pick up your secondary color. And we're going to attach it to any one of your corners. The corners are the chain two spaces. So I'm attaching my first strand of yarn, or my second strand of yarn, to the corner. Now we're going to chain three. Remember, your chain three counts as a double crochet. One, two, three. We're going to place two more double crochets to complete that cluster. One and two. Since this is a corner, we're going to make a corner side. To do that, you're going to chain two, one, two, and you're going to place another cluster right into the very same chain two space again. So back into the same space with your three. One, two, and three. And in between your corners, you're always going to chain one. That's considered part of your side. Now we're going to work the next corner just like this. We're going to do a cluster, chain two, cluster. I'll work that with you. One, whoops, messed that one up. One, two, and three. Since this is your corner, chain two, one, two, and place three more clusters into the ring. One, two, and three. And since this is considered the side right here, we're going to chain one. All right, we're going to repeat that sequence all the way around, doing a cluster, chain two, cluster, followed by chain one on each one of your corners right here and here. So pause your video here, continue placing your corners in, and I'll meet you at the other side. Okay, we've made it back around. I already completed my chain one, and we're going to slip stitch the join into the top of your chain three stitch. And once you have your join, fasten off your work. And we're going to switch colors again. You can connect your yarn to any one of your chain two corners. All right, since this is a corner, we're going to do as we usually do. We're going to chain three, one, two, three, place two more double crochets into the ring, not into the ring, into the space. One and two, chain two because it's the corner, one, two, and three more double crochets right back into that ring. Not the ring, the space. One, two, and three. Chain one. Right now, we're working on a side space. This is a chain one. In all of your chain one spaces, you're just going to put one cluster. So let's do that. That's three double crochets into this chain one space. One, two, and three. And chain one. And you're going to do a place your corner into your corner chain two space. So that's a cluster, chain two, cluster. And once you get to your side, you're going to do just a cluster in your chain one space. So you can pause your video here. Why don't you complete that sequence all the way around, and I'll meet you back at the other side. Okay, we made it back around, and I just slip stitched a join. We're going to repeat that same sequence for another three more rows. So for each one of your chain two spaces, that's your corner. You're going to do another corner stitch, which is a cluster, chain two, cluster. And for your chain one spaces on the side, you're just going to put one cluster into each one of your chain one. So it'll be a cluster, chain one, followed by another cluster, chain one, then work into your corner all the way around. So I'll meet you at the completion of those three rows. Okay, we have all our parts assembled. So this now we're going to take our scarf. We're going to fold it at the corners like so. And take your other side and fold it at the corner. Your two top pieces should be touching. And your bottom pieces are splayed out to the side. And we're going to take our granny square and turn it the wrong side facing up, because we're going to sew this on. Whenever you sew, you want to make sure you're working on the wrong side facing up. And place it right there. You can either sew along these edges to attach your granny square, or do slip stitching to attach your granny square. So you can go ahead and do this, and I'll show you what it looks like all assembled.